Hi, I'm Naomi Fenlin at About Face Skincare. I'm here with a patient of mine who has a little acne blemish on just under her lower lip, and we're going to do an extraction on that. She decided to get a little creative herself and give it a shot at trying to remove it, but we're going to take care of business our own way. So you can see it right down there. The first thing I'm going to do, let me take this light off, and the very first thing I'm going to do is to use the Isolaz, which is a photodynamic device, on it and see if we can't extract some of that stuff that's in there. I put a little bit of water on it at first, just like this, with a little piece of gauze. So just the tiniest bit of water, and place the device on top and pulse it, and look to see if we were able to pull anything up closer to the surface. And yes, indeed, right there, that little yellow spot is where the head of that pimple is, and that makes it a lot easier for us to take care of business. However, I'm going to try and pull it up even higher. So we're going to put a little bit more water on there. And we're not going to use the light, so you won't see any light flashing, but here we go. So just a little bit of a tug, and that just identifies it a little bit more precisely. And I'm going to put my magnifying lamp back on it. Okay, so I can see it much more precisely. And now we're going to start the actual extraction. I use a little antiseptic on a gauze. This doesn't sting, it doesn't hurt at all. And my tools are really simple. I have a regular old extractor you can buy in the drugstore, and I actually have a needle. I'm going to use this to lance the surface skin. Use my antiseptic on top of the skin. She's already washed and clean, but we're going to make sure that everything is really clean for her and we're not going to deposit more bacteria in there. Stretch the skin a little bit and just place the tip of the needle in right where you see that little yellow pocket.
So, Naomi, this is what you're doing, but should people at home be trying to take needles to their faces?
No, that's not a good idea for people to try to do this on themselves. There are a lot of reasons for that. One is simply the sterilization issue that's really hard to duplicate at home, but much more likely than not, the only thing that you're going to do at home with something like this is to make it a little bit worse, if not a whole lot worse. What's in here is a collection of dead skin cells and oil and bacteria. I'm going to use my extractor, put some pressure around that, may have to come back, make it a little bit bigger. And what you want to do is you want to make sure that you're going to be able to pull all of that stuff out and not actually drive it deeper underneath the surface of the skin, which is the danger when you're trying to do this on your own. And what happens if you do that is that this clump of solidified debris, which is what it really is, can break right through the bottom of the pore, go down deeper into the skin, if not right down into the subcutaneous fat below. Okay, so we've got the place where that infection really is, and you can see it starting to come out. And already, even though there will be a little bit of soreness from this, this is already feeling better, isn't it? Is that a yes?
Yes.
Okay. Just checking. All right, so we got part of it. All that yellow stuff is infection. We want to get rid of all of it, so we want to make sure, come at it from a couple different angles, make sure we've got it all. So you see that there's a little bit of, tiny bit of blood, tiny bit of fluid, that's just the fluid in the skin. And it looks like we've got almost everything. I think there may be a little pocket more in here because it looks slightly like the skin is slightly discolored towards the tip of my extractor. You see that right up there?
Yeah.
That may or may not be a tiny bit of more of what we want to extract. So despite the fact that this is sore, I want to just give it one more swipe. Like that. I'm sorry. And you can see that volume-wise, it's almost flat.
Yeah.
And I want you to take note The extractor has two ends on it. It's got a flat end on this side.
Yep.
And it's got another end that's quite a lot narrower. It's more like a wire. When you're doing an extraction or you're trying to do an extraction, don't ever use this wire side because it's very, very narrow. It can go right through the skin like a knife. So you want to use the wider end, as you see I've been doing. It's got a bigger hole to center the pimple in, but it also does much less tissue damage to the to the area around the pimple. So we just want to make sure we've gotten everything. And I want to come back with the Isolaz one more time. Make sure that everything has come out of there. And you can see we're really careful about being sterile. We don't reuse things. So I'm not going to use the light right away. The light kills bacteria and it damages the glands that produce oil, the sebaceous glands. But I want to just give it a tug. See if there's anything else left inside of there. And that's all clear. So there's nothing solid left in there. And I'm going to give it one more quick flash with the light, which will kill whatever bacteria is remaining in there and help it to heal really quickly. And in a day or two, this will be completely resolved. So here's our flash of light. And that's that. So thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you later. Bye.